Saw the city passing by my window. Was in the crowd, but I felt so alone. Looked at my phone like every other second. My future was blurry and numb. A tunnel where there's no light. Oh, but then you came and sat right next to me. Your eyes, they glowed and filled me up. We had never met before.
Yes.
take you out, show you the time of your life. I wanna figure out what it takes to give you everything you desire. I wanna lay beneath the stars with you in the back of my truck. I guess that this is what they call love. Baby, you've been driving me crazy for so long now. I've been waiting on the sidelines, praying for the right time to let you know. And stay in. Put a record on, let's hide the phones and make believe the world don't exist. Let's pull up ties and take a trip to someplace.
Support and to celebrate the joining together of Alicia and Chad in holy matrimony, and it is in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here in the sight of God and in the face of this wonderful company of witnesses to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted of God, signifying unto us the mystical union that is between Christ and his church, which holy estate that Christ adorned with his presence and his first miracle of his ministry at Cana. And it is commended of by the Apostle Paul to be honorable among all men, and therefore it is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, soberly, and in the fear of God. And it is into this holy estate that these two persons present come now to be joined. Chad, Alicia, all who are here with us tonight and are married, and of course to those of you who intend to be married someday, we take that holy estate of matrimony to be a very serious relationship, the most serious outside of our relationship with God. Now let's hear what Holy Scripture has to describe as the duty of husbands toward their wives and wives toward their husbands. Apostle Paul, in his letter to the Ephesians, in the 5th chapter, gives this commandment to all married men. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for her, that he might sanctify and cleanse her with the washing of water by the word, that he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love their wives as their own body. He that loveth his wife loveth himself, for no man ever yet hated his own flesh, but nourisheth and cherisheth, even as the Lord the church. For we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones, and for this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife. Chad and Alicia, having come to me, signifying your desire to be formally united in marriage, and being assured that no legal, moral, or religious barriers hinders this proper union, I ask that in the joining of your hands, you will now give heed to the questions I ask you. Chad, will you have this woman to be your lawful wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor her, bring honor to her, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep you only unto her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Alicia, will you have this man to be your lawful wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, bring honor to him, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep you only unto him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Chad, taking Alicia by her left hand, would you repeat these vows of the ring exchange after me? I, Chad, take you, Alicia.
I, Chad, take you, Alicia.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold to this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish forever.
To love and to cherish forever.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto I give you my pledge.
And thereto.
Alicia, taking Chad by his left hand, I ask you to repeat after me. I, Alicia, take you, Chad.
I, Alicia, take you, Chad.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish forever.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto I give you my pledge.
And thereto I give you my pledge.
These whom God hath joined together, let no one put asunder. Let us pray. O God, who has so ordained and consecrated the state of matrimony, that in it is represented the spiritual marriage and unity between Jesus Christ and his church, I pray that you will look mercifully upon these your servants, that they may love, honor, cherish one another, and so live together in faithfulness and patience, in wisdom and true godliness, that their home may be a haven of blessing and of peace, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit ever, one God, world without end. Amen. Chad and Alicia, having pledged your faith in and love to one another, and having sealed your solemn marital vows by the giving and receiving of rings, acting in the authority vested in me by the state of North Dakota, and looking to heaven for divine sanction, I now pronounce you husband and wife in the presence of God and these assembled witnesses. Therefore, let all of us take care in the sight of God that this holy covenant shall ever remain sacred. Chad, you may kiss your bride. Friends, family, it is my sincere pleasure and honor to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Chad and Alecia Gullickson. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the opportunity to join together as family and friends and neighbors, Lord God, associates, teammates, Lord God, to celebrate the joining in holy matrimony of Chad and Alecia. Now, Lord, we give you thanks for food. You're a great provider, and we pray your nourishment over it and bless those who blessed us with its preparation, and bless also the remainder of our fellowship and reception tonight. And it is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thanks for helping so far.
Yeah,
no problem. Hey. I like to help the girls too on that one.
Yeah.
But the idea is when I put the note in there, that way if he's on the
camera. Actually, I'm eating.
Chase
this and go to Grandpa.
Well, friends, once again, good evening and thank you for being here. We're going to be transitioning here in just a little bit with the rest of our reception. We're going to be doing some dancing and you don't want to see me dance. Okay. That's my gift to them is I'm not going to dance. Okay. So, but before we do, it's very meaningful to Chad and Alecia that I say a word about James Markison's passing tonight. And he passed away earlier, just prior to our ceremony here tonight. But they were so impacted, as many of you were, by James's life. So I wanted to say that on Chad and Alicia's behalf. And tonight it's certainly my honor to announce them for their first dance.
I never had no one that
could count on. I've been let down so many times. I was tired of hurting, so tired of searching, till you walked into my life. It was a feeling I'd never known. And for the first time, I didn't feel alone. Your mom.
Calling Canyon. Calling Canyon. Going to have a father and daughter dance.
No, he ain't perfect, but hell, who is? There ain't nothing that's broken that he couldn't fix. He taught me what to fight for and when to not give a damn. Yeah, I'm the proud daughter of a blue-collar Superman. I'm in good hands when he's holding on to mine. I know who I am when I look in his eyes, and he only sees the best in me. Even when it's hard to find, he's a good man. I'm in good hands. Well, Daddy, you'll grow to love him, because I do. And I know you're only worried, 'cause he's just like you. It taught me what I'm worth, and I'd never settle for any less. When we dance at night in the kitchen, I believe him when he says I'm in good.
Also at this time, Chad is going to find his mother, there she is, Vicky, and they are going to have a son and mother dance. About a minute in, I will motion to you, and we would welcome all sons and their mothers who would like to join them to also join them here on the floor.
I hope the days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more